Hey, what's up? In today's video, I'm gonna show you Pekka Balloon Freeze, really, really strong deck. With this deck, and I might finish number one last season, so strong, you have so many defensive tools. You have the Pekka Tornado Isis Baby Dank Freeze Commission, so strong. You have the Lumbaloon Push as the win commission with the Freeze, and if you have like this Pekka Baby Dragon Lumbaloon Freeze Push, you can't defend this. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. 61% of my viewers didn't subscribe yet to my channel. Would really appreciate that. And by the way, I'm going to upload this video on a different time than normal. Write in the comment section, you prefer this time or you prefer the other one? Because I saw in my analytics that a lot of my viewers are online on YouTube or watching videos in general at this time. So I kind of try to change it. If you guys prefer the orb, just let me know if you prefer this one right now. If you guys want to support me more, use credit code on shop. Really appreciate it. I'm going to see you in the first game with the anime deck. Let's go. So guys, you're in the first game against, I don't really know how to pronounce his name, Konacht? I think this guy is a German. So we're going with an Isis in the back and we want to start off the game kind of passive, want to control the game. Magic Archer kind of annoying because you don't have the poison. That's like a downside from this deck. You don't have a big spell, but you need to work a lot with your offensive plays with the Pekka, with the Lumberjack, pulling the troops into the Pekka. I would say I'm gonna go for Baby Dragon over here. And let's see. He's gonna do that. I think I need to tornado this. I think we need to Pekka that. Ah, our starting hand wasn't optimal. But it's still fine. We didn't take so much damage. This is a deck which like really, really is showing in double and triple licks at times. So he's going with the match card. He still has to defend it. Does he have a log? Does he have something else? He needs something. The Pekka's gonna get a hit otherwise. He one hit from the Pekka. He's gonna snowball, it's fine. So we're kinda back in this game. We go with Isis like that. Perfect Isis placement. Really, really nice. Really, really played. Well played by us. I think we're just going with a Lumberjack in the back. And let's see. He's going to go most likely with a Hunter. Okay, he's going with a Fisherman. Really great play by him. Because if he would have gone with a Hunter, I know he doesn't have anything against air anymore. Because he used a Snowball Magic Archer already. I just could have Loon Bridge. So let's see what he's doing. He's using his Hunter, so I'm just gonna go straight up with Balloon at the bridge. Oh, he has Ram Rider as well. Yeah, I didn't know that. I thought he has Royal Hawks. And the Ram Rider not connect. Let's go. Really, really nice defense. At least we know his deck now. At least we know it's a really interesting Ram Rider deck. I don't really know about that. We're gonna nail all of this into the Pekka. Ah, great E-Bubs. E-Bubs are insane. We're going in with a Lumberjack. He has Freeze as well, so we need to freeze the E-Bubs. Going in with a Ice Wizard here. This is tough. This is spicy. This guy's playing well so far, and he has a really, really good deck against us because we don't have that much against E-Bubs. And at the same time, he has Rambite in defense. And he has Freeze. If we go in with a Freeze too. Really great Freeze pass. I think now it's time to go in with a Balloon. He doesn't have Rambite and Cycle yet. He still needs to cycle one more card, so he's going with a Freeze. Great Freeze by him. Okay, I think now it's time to go in for a Pekka for us. It's fine if we take one hit. We need to take some damage here. He, that's a really aggressive Magic Archer. I wouldn't have played if I would have been him, but I'm not him. I'm going in with a Balloon here and we need to freeze. Can we win this game if we go in with a Tornado here?
What's happening in the last couple of videos? Wow, I can't believe it, guys. What's your next game against Legendary Pop and the last game? Man, this is insane. You just see that on my channel.
Kappa. So going in for good luck, and let's see what he's gonna play, let's see what he does. So I could Psycho Zap, I think I'm just gonna do it. He's gonna go for Electrosquid. So if I see Electrosquid, I think about maybe Expo or Hawk. So because it could be Expo, I don't really want to go from Pega because then he's just gonna go opposite lane with Expo. And it looks like it's gonna be Expo Cycle. Tough, we don't have a big spell. We have the Pekka, we have the Beyblade, so we need to play it really, really careful. I think right now, because he used all his troops, I'm just gonna go for Balloon here, just to bait out his Fireball. It's completely fine, he needs to go for Fireball. Oh, he has a Rocket. Okay, that's even better for us. At least in this situation, it was better for us, but I think in general, it might be worse because Rocket is way better against like this Pekka Baby Dragon pushes. Okay, he's going in with aggressive Expo. I don't know about that. For sure, it's gonna connect, but he doesn't have Skeletons in Cycle, so it's gonna die anyway. And right now, he's just to defend this. I think we still go for Baby Dragon here. Because of the Baby Dragon swing, we're gonna zap this. And he's gonna go scan, it's fine, but still, we can take a lot of Baby Dragon hits. I think he thought we are low on Elixir. The Expo from him was a big mistake for sure. He should have played it. So we get a ton of Baby Dragon chip, and that's the thing about the matchup. He has a lot of great cards, he has a Tesla, he has Expo to pressure, he can easily outcycle us. But the nice thing is, he doesn't have that much against Baby Dragon. For sure, he has the Archers, he has the Knight, but if he doesn't have the cycle, Skeletons are not that good against it. And Electrosquid as well. So we're going in with a. Okay. I think we just go in with a Balloon onto his Tesla because he needs to defend it anyway, because of the Rage. And if not, we get death damage. Okay. Electrospirit did a great job. Not gonna lie, going in with a high Baby Dragon here to kill his archers. And we still have a nice counter push. Okay, we're going in with a Pekka like that. Did he I think he messed the Expo up and I didn't see it. Kinda washed here. So we're going in with this. We're going in with a Tornado here. Just to pull everything in, going in for Ice Wizard in case he's gonna go Skeletons. And I think right now we're just gonna pressure him again with Baloo because he has to Rocket Dead. We're going in with a Zap. Zap kinda messed up, but shouldn't really matter. We're going with a. Going in with Tornado here in case he's gonna go Skeletons. Let's go. We need to go with a Freeze. And Ice Wizard. This is tough. He's playing well. Playing really, really well. This is not a good matchup, I think, and he's playing good. We're going in for Freeze. I don't think the Freeze was necessary, but I had to do it in case he's gonna save it more, and right now we are looking. It's looking really, really bad. We're going in with that and we will need to zap this. Then we need to go in with a Baby in case he's gonna go with Skeletons. He's not. He just needs to lock Cygars. Ah, he's playing well. He played it really, really well, to be honest. I can't deny that. Even I think it's a really tough matchup for us. I think this guy played well. Well played to him. And as I said, it's fine to show losses in the video for me. Write a comment deck. I think losers, it's always nice to show losers. This deck has struggles against Expo in general. You need to be animated for that. That's the little thing. If you play against a really, really good 2.9 player, it's so tough to win. But I'm just going straight up jumping to the next game. Let's go. So guys, we're in the next game against Napoleon. Good luck to him. Let's see what he's playing. Good luck. Good luck, dude. We're going for Ice in the back. And he's gonna go drop a Tombstone. So, going in with a Zap. Baby Dragon in the back. He's going with Barb, so it could be Lava Loon. I think I just want a Pekka here, to be honest. I think it's the move to do, going in with an early Pekka. Because how is he supposed to punish us? He could go in with a Balloon, yes. But we're just gonna activate King Tower with it. Easy King to activation. Then we can again go with Balloon on our side, plus an Ice Wiz. Let's go, great Ice Wiz. He's gonna go in with a... how's it called? Mega Man and Tombstone, so he defended it. Not that bad. I'm going in with a Lumberjack now, just to pressure him a bit that he has to play his Barbs. Yes, he has to. Because we can just clean up with a Baby, then we played high, because then we have still the Rage. And because he does have Mega Man inside, it's completely fine for us. What's he gonna do now? He's gonna drop arrows. Why did we get so much damage on the right side? I can't really remember what happened there. Here, thing now. I wanna go with a Pekka to the opposite side. And kinda tower trade here. I think this is how we play the matchup. Because I don't think we can defend. Going for Baby Dragon. Where do we get this tower is the question. Okay, going into freeze ace it. Going for Zap as well. I think this is gonna be one hit. Yes. He's going for lightning. But it's gonna be one hit, it's fine. Because our king does low as well. He uses Mega Minion, so we go in with a balloon. Come on, Rage! Come on, Rage! Come on, Rage! He's using arrows, okay. At least he spent some elixir. Okay, we're going in with that. Nado as late as possible. That was aggressive lighting by him. I don't know if I would have played it. Okay. Man, these games are intense, honestly. But I love it. I love that. Prefer to have, like, spicy gameplay and, like, really, really... We can bypass that. No, we can't because of the Mega Man push. Oh, unfortunate. What is he gonna do, you know? I hope the Baby Dragon is able to. And for sure, we need to go in here. Well played. This guy played well. Oh my. Ah, tough. Tough. We don't have that match against Lavaloon. For sure, we have Isis Baby Dragon, but if he's gonna like fireball that, he has minions against air. That was tough. He played well. I would say we do one more game with this Enderman deck. And that's the thing. That's the thing about the deck. Nobody can play it really on top ladder. Nobody's gonna finish top 200 with this deck. But one guy's playing it perfect. That's Alna Band. That's why he's finishing number one with it. Nobody's as good with his deck. Not even close to it. I'm gonna see you next game. I hope we can close out the video with at least another win. I'm gonna see you next game against Fabiano. And I hope we can close out the video with a win. This deck, I don't really know. It's a really, really weird deck. The thing is, like, I think I'm good or like now to play every meta deck, but because this is not a meta deck, nobody's playing it in CL or nobody's playing it in general besides Enderman. It's so tough. He's going in with the Barbard Law. That's why, that's like the thing. A good tip for you guys, a lot of you guys are always asking why you play the balloon in this spot. If you go opponents going with a low building, going in with a Goblin Cage like that, like low or the Barbard Law, you can bypass it. So That's the reason why you want to go for loot to the safe spot, if you can call it like that. It looks like this guy's playing Graveyard, so Hacker's doing some work against the Barfart. Go with that one over here. Let's see. Man, Packer's a good card. I think now it's time to go in for Bellblank. I prefer playing Bellblank right now because he can't really poison it and it's like in the air. So let's see what he's gonna do. I'm gonna go for Bellblank. I'm just gonna support by Bellblank for Ice Whiz. And if he's gonna play Musketeer here, then we can just go Balloon Opposite, naked. For Lumber here. Let me go in with another Balloon here. Again in the safe spot. You're going for Tornado like that. This is like what I meant with offensive tornadoes. Offensive tornadoes are so strong in this situation because the opponent, they can't really do anything. They can't really block because even if they play skeletons, the skeletons are going to die from Tornado. That's why offensive tornadoes are so strong to stack, and this is how you have to play the deck. Pekka, Tornado, Lumberjack, Tornado, Baby Dragon, Tornado. Like, this is like the combination how you win the game. So I would say we're just going to go for another Pekka and then back to the left side this time. I don't really think he can break through. He can break through our tower. Not to our tower, like getting our tower, I mean. He's trying it. For sure he's getting some damage right now. How is he supposed to defend this? We're going for another tornado. And he can't defend Pekka Loon. He can't defend it. He can't defend it. That's like insane. You love to see it. So if you're stuck against Barbat Graveyard, this is the deck you want to play, I think. Because the opponent has like just Musketeer or like Ewis against air. And if they have like out, Pekka's doing good against Barbat. Baby Dragon, offensive tornado, really, really strong. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe. Let me feedback in the comment section about the upload time. Write in the comment section which videos you guys want to see next. I have a lot of nice videos planned for you guys. And I want to see one of my next videos. Peace out. Thanks for watching and goodbye.